Apple is pushing a huge update to their macOS platform, and it packs a ton of new features that improve overall user experience. But rather than going over 100 new features in a single video, we're going to take a look at what I think are the coolest new features of macOS Mojave. So of course the highlight feature for most people in macOS Mojave is the new and enhanced dark mode. Now, we had dark mode in High Sierra, but all it really did was give you a dark dock and a dark minibar along the top. But in Mojave, they've really made dark mode what it should be. To enable dark mode, we first have to go to the top left corner and click on the Apple icon, then click System Preferences, then click General, and as you can see, you're able to choose a light or dark appearance. So I'm just going to go ahead and click Dark. And now we're in dark mode. So you can pretty much use all the first party apps from Apple in dark mode. And I'm just gonna open a couple of apps so that you can see for yourself what dark mode would look like. All right, opening up Notes. Easier on your eyes, I guess. Now we're gonna open up Calendar. Looking pretty sleek. Up next, we've got Mail. No pun intended. Contacts. And surprisingly, Maps also has dark mode too. And keep in mind that third-party developers will actually be able to make their apps operate in dark mode. So over time, we're going to see more and more apps taking advantage of this feature. With every new Mac update, we get a new wallpaper. But this time, Apple gave us not one, but a whole bunch of new wallpapers. So the main wallpaper that you're looking at right now actually features the Mojave Desert that is primarily located in California. And I think Apple really went with the desert theme this year. I'll show you what I mean. So let's go to System Preferences, Desktop and Screensavers. And as you can see, we've got a whole new selection of wallpapers. So I'm gonna show you how they look. Here's Mojave Day, Mojave Night, Desert 1, Desert 2, Desert 3, Desert 4, Desert 5, Desert 6, and finally, Desert 7. So yeah, you can see Apple really went with the desert theme this year. And on top of that, they also decided to add a bunch of colorful wallpapers to give it a twist. I mean, there's just so many wallpapers here, I don't even know what to choose. And although all these wallpapers look really good, I don't think I'm going to be using any of them. Why? Well, that's because Apple introduced Dynamic Desktop. So with Dynamic Desktop, your wallpaper actually automatically changes throughout the day based on your location and your time. I'm just going to open up the date and time preferences. And I'm going to manually adjust the date and time just to show you what I'm talking about. And here's what your wallpaper will look like when you wake up at 7:30 in the morning. Okay, and now we have lunchtime. Here's what it will look like in the evening. And this is what it will look like at night. Now, although this feature is pretty cool, I think they can make it more dynamic by adding weather effects. So if it's raining or snowing in your area, then it should also be reflected on your dynamic desktop. It'd be really neat to have, so Apple, if you're listening, please add this in the future. One reason why I've always preferred Skype over FaceTime is because of its ability to support group calls. But in macOS Mojave, this is no longer the case. FaceTime will now have the ability to support a group call up to 32 people. I mean, this is absolutely bonkers. I really can't imagine having a group call with 32 people. But if you guys can think of a situation where you'd need 32 people in a FaceTime call, let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear it. Anyways, unfortunately, Apple has announced that this feature will not be readily available until later this year. And this is because people have reported a lot of bugs when using this feature on FaceTime, so we're just gonna have to be patient and wait until they patch things up. If you hit Command Shift 5 on macOS Mojave, you actually get a new screen capture menu along the bottom. And from here, you get to choose from all your traditional screen capture options. So we've got Capture Entire Screen, Capture Selected Window, and Capture Selected Portion. And what's neat is that beside it, we have a new screen record button. And I'm actually using this feature to record my screen right now. It's actually really convenient because you no longer have to open up a separate app just to record your screen. And this saved me a lot of time and effort when making this video, so props to Apple for that. Anyways, I'm just gonna go ahead and take a screenshot. And as you can see, the image appears along the bottom right side, the same way it does on your iPad and iPhone. And if you go ahead and click on it, you're actually able to mark it up before you save it or share it, which is pretty cool and can be pretty useful when annotating things. If you're like me and you tend to have a messy desktop with files floating everywhere, then you're probably really gonna like this new feature called Stacks. So what Stacks basically does is it organizes all the files on your desktop into related categories. If you go ahead and open up your drop-down menu, you'll see the new feature listed right in the middle. And when you click on it, bam, all your files are neatly organized into stacks along the side. And from here, you can expand the stack and easily locate your files. So if I click Screenshots, then I can see all the screenshots that are initially located on my desktop. And after that, you can collapse the stack to make it neat and tidy again. Now, you can actually group the stacks into your own preferred categories. So as you can see here, we got date added, date created, date modified. I'm just gonna go ahead and click date added. And now the files on my desktop have been reorganized the way I like it. Last but not least, we have a super handy feature called Continuity Camera. And this will work with many Mac apps such as Pages, Mail, and Notes. It essentially allows you to conveniently take a photo or scan documents on your phone and directly import it onto your Mac. So right now, I'm in Notes, and all you have to do to use this feature is right-click where you want to insert the photo, click Take Photo, and you should see the camera app appear on your iPhone. And after taking a photo, just click Use Photo, and you should see the image appear on your Mac. And honestly, as a university student, I can really see myself and many others use this feature to take notes during lectures. And I hope the developers over at Microsoft will allow this feature to work in OneNote and Word, because those are the two programs most students take notes with. With this feature, you can also scan documents. And the process is essentially the same. When you're in the camera app, you have to position the document so that it fits onto your screen. Once you're ready, take the photo and it will appear on your Mac. Now, I have to admit, I was really surprised at how good the quality was on this. It almost looked like I used my scanner for this. I mean, I really couldn't find anything wrong with the scan. The text was just so crisp to the point where I couldn't even tell that it was from my iPhone. I have to say, I think this might be my favorite new feature of macOS Mojave. I mean, just look at this. It's absolutely beautiful. Also, please keep in mind that if you want to use this feature, you have to update your iPhone's operating system to iOS 12. So don't forget to do that. Anyways guys, thanks for watching, and let me know down in the comments below what your new favorite feature is. And if you haven't already, please hit the subscribe button and leave a thumbs up if you found this video helpful. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.